A very good morning, my dear class 2 students. I'm Anisha ma'am and I will be taking your online English classes. So welcome my dear students. So girls, before we start, I just wanted to share something with you. So my dear students, I hope you all are doing well and are in great health. I'm already so proud of each one of you for being so patient during these hard times. But remember, everything is possible when everyone is fighting for something together. And how would our class fight this together? By remembering to wash our hands regularly, by eating proper food, by reading and playing, and by sleeping on time. Do you know what else you have to do? Remember to smile. Remember to tell yourself that you are very strong, smart, and capable of anything. Remember to compliment your family and friends. Do you know what else we can do? We can write imaginary stories, we can draw, we can sing, we can dance, and we can listen to good music. I wish well for all of you. Lots of love, Anisha ma'am. And girls, I just want to tell you that we all miss you a lot. The empty classrooms, corridors, upper and lower field, everything is so dull without you. We just hope and pray that the situation comes under control and we all can meet each other soon. So let's all just close our eyes, join our hands and say this short prayer. Dear God, please give me the strength to face the day and to see the many blessings that it contains. Give me the courage to walk on, no matter how long the path or how many turns the road holds. Guide my thoughts so that I walk in love and peace and with gratitude stamped on my heart. Amen. So girls, now we are all set to start with our class. So in the previous classes, we learned about cursive writing, sentences and jumble words. I hope you have carefully read all the lessons and have completed the exercises. So now today we'll start with punctuation marks. We all know that we did this in class 1, so it will be a quick revision. So let me start with the definition of punctuation marks. What are punctuation marks? A punctuation mark is a mark which is used in writing to separate sentences and to clarify their meanings. So we have different types of punctuation mark. Can you identify these punctuation marks? If yes, then quickly tell that to your parents. So here we have the first one, the question mark, second full stop, third comma, and fourth capital letter. So now I will tell you about each one of them. The first one is capital letters. A sentence will always begin with a capital letter. For example, she is going to the market. Here, the first letter S is in capital letter. Second point, all the special names will also begin with a capital letter. For example, Amrita is going to Jaipur with Shaina. So now here we have three special names, that is Amrita, Jaipur and Shaina. Amrita and Shaina are the names of people. Jaipur is the name of a place, so it's in capital letter. Now the third point is the pronoun I is always written in capital letter wherever it appears, whether it is in the beginning of the sentence or in between of the sentence. I is supposed to be always in capital letter. For example, Sheena and I are sisters. Here I is in between the sentence. It doesn't matter, I has to be always in capital letter. Now what gets a capital letter? Names of people and pets, Like Lucy, Joe, Sally, all these are names of people. So these are written in capital letter. The first letter is written in capital letter. The names of Pet, Max, and Coco. Here, the first letter of the word is written in capital letter. Then we have letter I, which I have already spoken about in the previous slide. Next, we have names of places, McDonald's, Greenwave, Canada Inn, all are in capital letters. The first letter is in capital letter. Then we have names of holidays, Christmas, Diwali, Dashera. Then we have days of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday till Saturday. Then we have months, January, February, March till December. All the first letters you can see here are written in capital letters. Is it clear, girls? I hope these points are clear to you. Now we move on to the next, that is full stop. Every sentence that is a statement ends with a full stop. For example, I am watching a movie. This is a statement, so it ends with a full stop. The third one is question mark. Now, if a sentence is asking question, it will end with a question mark. For example, what are you doing? The sentence is asking a question, so it ends with a question mark. Now, look at the anchor chart, which is given on the right side of the screen. Here we have a lot of questions like, why does a vacuum make noise? It's a question, so it ends with a question mark. How is your hot dog? Then it's a question, so it ends with a question mark. Do you like apples? Did your rocket break? So all these are questions, so it all ends with a question mark. So now we move on to the next slide, and the fourth one, that is comma. Comma is used to separate three or more words in a list. For example, I love mango, apple, grapes, and banana. Here we have three fruits and we have to separate that. So to separate all these, we are using comma. That is, I love mango, comma, apple, comma, grapes, and banana. Now here on the right side of the screen, we have an anchor chart. Commas in a series. A shark, a crab, a jellyfish, a seahorse, a diver, an octopus, a sea turtle, a whale, a dolphin, a stingray, and some fish all live in the ocean. Now here we have so many sea animals and one diver. You can see that in this picture. So we have to separate all these. So we have used comma over here. I hope now all the four punctuation marks are clear to you. Now we move on to one exercise. Punctuate the following sentences. I am pretty sure that all of you know the answer. The first one, when is your birthday? So I hope you know the answer. This is a question. So here we are using, in the beginning of the sentence, as I spoke to you, we start all the sentences with a capital letter. So capital letter W, and we are going to end this sentence with a question mark because this is a question. The person is asking us a question that when is your birthday? The second sentence, I love ice cream. Here, I told you I will be capital because this is the beginning of a sentence, and we are going to end the sentence with a full stop because this is a statement. I love ice cream. The third one, my mom and I went to the park. Now here we are going to have capital letter in the beginning of the sentence M. The letter will be capital letter. Then we have I, as I told you that I, whether it is in the beginning or in the middle, is always supposed to be in capital letter. Then you're going to end the sentence with a full stop as it is a statement. Fourth one, we had pizza for lunch. Here also we are going to begin the sentence with a capital letter, so capital letter W, and we're going to end the sentence with a full stop because this is a statement. Now in the fifth sentence, we have Ram, Shyam, and Radha are playing. Now here we have list of names of people. So now what do we have to do? The first sentence, the first letter will be capital letter. Then we are going to put a comma. Then the name Shyam. So here it will be capital letter S. Then we are going to have Radha. It will also be capital letter. Why? Because these all are names of people. Ram, Shyam and Radha. So these all are going to be in capital letter. And we have a full stop. We are going to put a full stop at the end of the sentence. Because this is a statement that Ram, Shyam and Radha are playing. So girls, with this, we end today's session. Thank you, girls. Stay home, stay safe, and stay happy. Now, I'll meet you in the next week with a new lesson. Till then, bye-bye, girls. Take care.